Alright, now we have task 3. Use EM stop switch to create a safety circuit for RO2. Now we have to add an E-stop button, which also support IST. So here in this case, you can see the inputs are IN3 and IN4. Okay, so let's see how we can do that. We go back to our circuit, which we defined in the last example, go off from the live mode, and in the equipment, I will add another input. In this case, I have an IST device again, so I go here, and this will automatically tell me which inputs are available. So we have IN3 and IN4. Number of devices is just one, and this device in our case is emergency stop. Device name I can type EM stop, and this IST chain I can also write EM stop. I can't write the whole keyword, but I can just try to negotiate with my name. So I write E-stop, click OK, and now your input is connected here. Very easy. All you have to do is now make a circuit for RO2. And if you just want to see the wiring of E-stop, this E-stop is connected to IN3 and IN4 with this example you have seen here. So it gets 24 volt to the white wire, gray wire, and pink wire, all connected to 24 volts. And it's also connected to a reset button, which is optional. And you have 0 volt connected to wire green, and these are the two outputs, Q1 and Q2. Okay, going to IN3 and IN4. Very nice. So let's go to the functional view, and this button should control my RO2. Simple, just drag and drop. And download, write configuration, if you want to save your changes to the project, which is okay. I will write here as task 3, save, enter the password, my default password for the controller, click okay. This will turn off the output. That's fine for me. Outputs are off, program is downloaded, final confirmation, and then your program is downloaded and ready to use. In this case, I don't want to change the password. I need to restart the controller again. So I will restart it very quickly. This is OS. The controller is restarted now, and you can see that the output status of relay is true, and for RO2 it's not true. So let me just unplug my cable, plug it again to go to the live mode. So now I can go to the live mode, and you can see that the status of these two door switches are true. So my RO1 is true. Some communication failure, but it's okay. And E-stop is false, so RO2 is false. So let's reset my E-stop. Now in this case, my RO2 is also true. So my circuit is safe. Both of my outputs are true. Let's check it again. Magnetic switch, circuit. This will turn off RO1. And now we have some problem with magnetic switch. It has a false input detection. Now it's live again. Similarly for E-stop, my RO2 is off because E-stop is pressed, E-stop is released, RO2 is true. So in this software, it makes it so easy to realize what your inputs are doing, what is your program inside, and how your output is reacting. It's very easy icon-based programming software. And you can also see that a live mode and IST mode for your in-series diagnostic for E-stop and your buttons. Once again, if you press the E-stop here, you will see the signal in the E-stop. This is getting red. So IST chain is false and my RO2 is false. I can release it to see the status back on my software. Similarly here, I can also break the loop and go back to my outputs. So this was the idea of our task 3, in which we just have to connect EM stop to RO2. Now in the next task, we have to use an LR block, latch or unlatch blocks, to make a safety circuit, and we're going to use a manual reset switch to reset or set the block. Okay, let's see that in the next video.